Hi, it's Gordon here at Avolites, and I'm going to explain some of the tracking options that we have inside cuelists. Inside our cuelist view, which we can access either by tapping the grey space in between the legend and the blue swap button of a cuelist, or alternatively, we can tap view and we can tap the blue swap button of a cuelist to get this information up on screen. We have a column that is called tracking. There's a number of different options inside this tracking column so that we can make our lives easier and a little bit more efficient. The first thing that I want to show you guys with tracking is in this options tab here. We've got a switch which will turn tracking on or off for the entire cue list. We've also got an additional section which can deal with shape tracking. Shapes track differently to other values inside our cue list. So we can turn shape tracking off, we can turn it on, or we can turn it just locally to this specific cue list. Anyway, I'll go back to my cue list view and I'll explain a few of these options. Tracking we can set individually across every cue inside a cue list. What global is going to do is it is going to allow any information from cue 1 to carry on going up until we give these lights some new instructions. If I turn some lights on in Q1 and I don't do anything with them while I'm recording Qs 2 and 3, those lights are going to stay on because we haven't given them any new instructions. Then in Q4, if I want to turn them off, I can select those lights, turn them to 0% intensity and record that information in Q4. This makes my life a lot easier because alternatively, I'd have to put instructions for those lights in Qs 1, Qs 2, Qs 3. And then later on, if I wanted to change their color or change their position, I'd have to update Qs 1, Qs 2, Qs 3, and then still turn them off in Q4. If I select one or a number of these cells and have a look at my soft keys, you can see that I have some different options. The first one is global. This is going to keep this information tracking based on an entire setting over the console. I can tell cues that I want them to track specifically by tapping soft key B. This means that any instructions that I've got in Q1 are going to carry on up until I give these lights some new instructions. Soft key C says block. This is really useful for things like interval states or states in between bands. If I've got a block instruction in this tracking column, then any information that is being tracked from beforehand is going to be stopped at this point, and it's not going to carry on going any further. Solo excluding shapes is the next one that we have on our soft keys. And this is going to display information that is in this cue, just inside this cue. Because it's solo, it's going to keep any information that is being tracked by the console from here, and it's going to keep it going afterwards. It's just going to skip over this particular cue. It says excluding shapes, so this is going to allow shapes that are being tracked on these cues here beforehand to carry on tracking through this cue and afterwards. Cue only is the next option we have, which is going to allow any information that we have being tracked beforehand to carry on tracking down as you'd expect. But the information that is stored inside this cue is only going to be displayed inside this cue. And this particular piece of information is not going to carry on tracking afterwards. What Solo does is it will allow any shapes that are being tracked beforehand to skip past this key, so they won't be displayed in this current key, and they'll carry on going after that. This is the same with any other information. Any information that's being tracked in this example from keys 1 to 9 are going to skip keys 10 and go back in to the coming out of the console from queue 11 onwards. The final option that we have is block shapes. This is going to carry on information that's being tracked beforehand to carry on tracking through as you'd expect. But this particular cue is going to stop any shapes from tracking. It's going to put a complete stop in there. If I scroll to the right-hand side of this window, you can see that there is a view shape column. This is because rather than normal values that we put into our cue lists, shapes track independently. You can see on this cue list, I've got a number of keyframe shapes, and I've got a few color and dimmer shapes as well. One of the things that is really useful, if I have spent a lot of time building myself up a complex keyframe shape, and I go, okay, well, I'd actually like this keyframe shape to appear in cues 4, 5, and 6, rather than trying to make this keyframe shape exactly the same and merging this information in here, and in here, I've got a toggle switch for each individual shape. If I flick that toggle switch to T, then that keyframe shape is going to be tracked further forward. If I switch it to B, then that's going to be blocked. So this is where this keyframe shape is going to stop appearing. If I've spent an hour, 2 hours, whatever it may be, making this keyframe shape, and I want it to appear in a few more cues, I can switch that switch so it says T, and when I want it to stop appearing, I can switch it so that it says B. This saves me a lot of valuable time programming. You can see in this Q14, I've got a yellow shape running. If I switch that, I can switch that as well, and you can see that that yellow shape has disappeared. That's because in this particular queue, I'm blocking any shapes from continuing. These two sets of tracking information work really nicely hand in hand. You can see in this queue, if I say solo, any shapes that have been recorded in here are going to skip that and carry on going further forward. So if you've got a basic understanding of these and you make sure that you practice using them, you can save yourself a lot of valuable time editing and working with tracking. It's all based on these options here. If I turn tracking off, then what it's going to do is it's going to turn tracking off for this entire cue list that I'm currently working in. But using this tracking column and this view shape column and these great switches, I can make editing my cue list and certainly in demanding show environments make my life a lot easier. Thank you for watching, and tune in for the next video.